At the outset, let me thank Madhu for inviting me to be a part of this first conference of Kathak and Choreography in remembering Guru Maya Rao. Biruda, as he is fondly known, always spoke about Maya Didi and her work, but unfortunately I never got a chance to meet her. So, and also I was, it was very sensitive of Madhu to include him here in this particular conference. So I would just like to begin with a small film which I have made remembering Biru from various kind of all the small clips what I had. I've collected and compiled and collated together. The video quality is not too good because Biru always said, "Mujhe record mat karo aap, because I know my next performance will be better, so this is not good, so don't record this." So he always wanted never to record it, but somehow we used to sneak in some videographers and try and capture his abhinay and his thought. So I'm just giving a glimpse of remembering Biru.
Who was a storyteller? Kathak, ancient dance art form of storytelling, was his medium. Bireshwar was inclined towards Kathak since childhood. Bireshwar's penchant for the art of Kathak was similar to Radha's devotion for Lord Krishna. Culturally groomed in West Bengal, Biru leaped a number of hurdles to follow his passion, Kathak and Thumri. One of the finest male Kathak dancers, Bireshwar introduced rare dimensions to his dance that were enchanting and would possibly bring life to inanimate objects.
One of the old aspects of Kathak, which today is not available, nowadays you can't see this way. So, acting as a partner and all hand gestures, body movements, because we cannot go here and there. This will have to show all body language, all ghungat, and then make as the
director from Srimati Vandana Sen and Pandit Gopi Krishna of the Banaras Gharana. He spent many years training under the Padma Shri Damayanti Joshi. His talent as a vocalist was groomed by Sri Sanyam Pal, Pandit Vasantra Kulkarni, and Pandit Viya Achaman. Srimati Shobha Gurtu was his mentor and guide for many years.
His major contribution to Kathak dance and music was his signature thaat on Vilambit Khayal. And his Chaman Ki Thumri or Adakari Thumri, which unravels itself through both the words and the actions, the expressions and the gestures, the hand movements and the voice of the singer by sitting at one place. Biru's humility earned him a respectable position amongst the stalwarts. In spite of winning many prestigious felicitations and awards, Biru respected human values and continued living a modest lifestyle, winning hearts of his friends and students.
Bye.
is more than just an alap. It is a continuity of his legacy of music and dance.
I'm a little overwhelmed seeing this at this particular platform. As Biru always said, he always told us that whenever he participated in such conferences or such gatherings with all the scholars sitting here, and so he was the most nervous one, like I am today. And he says, I cannot talk. Everybody is such a great orator. They talk so well. They have such command over language. He said, my only medium of talking is through my dance. So that's all what I can do. And that's when he started dancing, I guess he just got lost in his dance. And he took the audience along with him in such a way that even the audience moved along with him on his dance. So as we saw in the film, his biggest contribution or his signature contribution to the Kathak dance was his signature Vilambit Thaat on the Vilambit Khayal. Now, we have seen Thaat, of course, is a very common thing in Kathak, and everybody does beautiful Thaats. But he said, as a singer, I want to explore something different, where there are no bowls of the Thaat, there are no bowls of tabla, there's no bowls of dance bowls. But on the alap of the khayal, why can't I move my body? Why can't I show the thought? Thought is nothing but your expression of how you are posing, how you're standing, and how you're moving with the music. So that's what he tried to develop. And of course, the second part was being a singer. He says, why can't I sit and revive the old tradition of Jaman Ki Thumri, where you sit and talk, sing, and show the abhinay. I remember one anecdote when I was there accompanying him with when he was going to Shobha Gotuji for teaching the Thumris. So what used to happen is all his contemporaries like Shobha Joshi or Dhanashri Pandit or all the other girls who were learning Thumri from Shobhaji or Mummy, as they fondly called. And they always said that, hum, Biru, tumhare program ke baad hamara program kabhi nahi hota. So you, if you have to do the program, if you have to sing, it has to be the last one. Because if you start singing and if you start performing, nobody's going to listen to us. So they asked, all the girls got along and ganged up and asked Shobhaji, कि इसमें ऐसी क्या बात है, आप हमेशा इनको ये सिखाते हो, आप तो सिखाते तो सबको एक ही चीज़ है, लेकिन ऐसी क्या बात है कि भई आप उनको बोलते हो कि नहीं कुछ तो अलग बात है. He says, ये जब ये लड़का गाता है तब ये नाचता भी है साथ में अंदर, तो इसीलिए वो जो हरकतें हैं वो गले से भी निकलती है उसकी, इसीलिए यही कुछ अलग दिखाई देता है. सो आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू शो यू two clips I've tried to compile. One of his is the Vilambit Khayal with Thaat, which was it. And one is a Kajri, what he was famous for. Just small clips. I know it's a long clip. I'll tell Kirti just to stop in between. But just the Thaat.
Thank you.
just a short like that was, he kept on exploring the music and he kept on doing, his heart would go on up to almost around 10 to 15 minutes and Vilambit, and nobody would get bored looking him move at this particular pace. There was a certain thairav in the whole dance, which he always attributed it to Damayanti Didi's training. And once I remember in this particular program itself, Leela Ji was there, Leela Venkatraman Ji, and she was there in the audience, and she wrote a review on this, and she just mentioned one word that Kubahub, we saw a Xerox copy of Damayanti Ji. Reading this, Damayanti Didi got so upset. She said, "Acha, abhi to aap Xerox ho gaye ho, to fir abhi kal se mat aana seekhne." And then yet he would keep on going there, and after almost waiting for almost every day, going there, talking to him, talking to her, sitting almost for 1.5 years, not teaching anything. Suddenly she got up and says, "Kyun? Bahut seekh liya kya? Seekhna nahi hai aage? Chalo, bandho gungru aur khade reh jao." So it was very typical of those kind of gurus, where they had their own temperament and yet they wanted to give something, but she realized that this is a guy whom she never taught, first of all, male dancers. She just refused. But when she saw him dance and sing, she says, "Haan, main tumhe sikhaungi." So again, another skill what he had was the singing, which he learned from Shobhaji also. So I would like to show one of his very favorite kajris, which somebody today, I think Deepti ji mentioned, "Baithe Soche Brijaban." So he also used to sing an emote on this. So just a small clip on that.
राधा कैसे कृष्ण के लिए कितनी बेचैन है और कैसे उनकी घबराहट होती है, और बाद में आई सावन की बाहर परिमंडन की कृपा, किस तरह से वो फिर उनके पिछले दिनों की याद करती है तीसरी भाव में।
Thank you.
Now this is one of the reasons why I cannot tolerate any mediocre Kathak. So after being learning from him and after seeing him perform, we keep on telling him, you have gone, but you have spoilt us and gone. Now we can't like anything which is mediocre. So I don't know I should be doing this or not, but in front of such erudite scholars and gunijans and gurus and all that, I'm trying to attempt something very, very small. His Vilambit Khayal, what he sung on, and after that, a small bet ke bhav, trying to show that. The khayal, what he sung, is in Jaunpuri, but it's a very long piece, so I'll just cut it short. I'll tell Kirti to stop there and then do the bet ke bhav, which is also on one of his favorite Lakshan Geet, Niratata Dhanga. So,
Thank you, Piyush ji, for sharing the stories, anecdotes, and the works of Pandit Bireshwar Gautam ji with us. It is indeed a blessing to watch him perform, even if it's through the medium of a video recording. We would like to invite Piyush ji back on stage, and member of the executive body, Rajendra ji, and Nirupama Rajendra ma'am, to please come up on stage and give him a small token of our appreciation.